Well, we are an Australian UK company, and the original sort of monkey magic was huge, obviously, in the late 70s and 80s in Australia and the UK. And Emile Sherman, who runs the Australian office, was always mad on that story and mad on the genesis of the original journey to the West. And we wanted to do something for our kids that, you know, with a whole new interpretation and a whole new approach to that original story. We wanted to bring something that was, you know, kung fu action adventure with laughs and fun for a wide family audience. And it was a real thrill to be able to kind of reinvent the story and find a whole new landscape and a whole new fantasy background to tell that story to you know, to my kids, to his kids, to Hakan's kids. It's something we were really thrilled to get into.
Great story, actually, that underpins the mythology of Monkey, and it's been adapted many times in lots of different languages and cultures, and we thought it'd be good to do one that was try to reach a global audience. And with Netflix coming on board and our Australian partners as well, ABC and New Zealand as well, TVNZ, it just felt like a fantastic opportunity to bring that story to the world again with a fresh new outlay on it. Well, we've got four very young, super talented cast members taking the lead, and some quite well-known names in the Australian and New Zealand television landscape. But I think they've brought a sort of a fantastic kind of magic to the screen with their performances. They are very talented, really exciting. I mean, they've been through the mill with the training, with their kung fu training beforehand, but they really delivered 100% on that.
It's a story in lots of different ways about finding, you know, the strength within yourself, finding who you really are, and being strong enough to live up to that that sense of self. And it's so there's fun to be had, but there's a gentle sense of characters finding themselves. And I think Luciani, Chai, Emily, and Josh are all sort of deliver, you know, wonderfully different range of qualities from the comic to they've all got natural comic instincts, but they all have a real physicality and they just threw themselves into the whole process of taking on these iconic characters, and with their different or their characters have different strengths and, you know, quasi superpowers and different weaknesses and flaws, and they were just a brilliant bunch of really committed actors, and who threw themselves into it with real gusto. It was fantastic.
Well, it's a quest, isn't it? It's a journey, and it's about self-discovery as well as, you know, achieving what you're setting out to do. And they're disparate characters. They're all very different. I remember discussing it with some of the cast members, and they, you know, it was quite interesting. You know, Emily, who plays Sandy, was saying, you know, that character is the outcast. She's the, you know, she lives on the outcast of society. She dresses and looks different to everybody else. And she was saying, you know, like, everyone can identify that within their own environment, whether it's school or work. You know, there's always that person that sort of might be on the peripheral, but really it's just as much heart and energy and direction and focus as anybody else. And sort of bringing them into the fold and going on that journey together with them, I think, speaks to a lot of people.
Yeah, I totally agree. It's about a diverse group of people coming together, and, you know, teamwork makes the dream work is the sort of at the heart of it. But it's also about finding out who you are in order to be able to really contribute to a team. And so it's got, I think, wonderful, you know, messages for kids, but it's also, you know, fun and action packed, and, you know.
I think the other thing to remember is it's they all had fun making it, and that comes across, I think, when you watch it. You know, it is a very energized performance by everybody, and I think that story, you know, deserves it. It's great fun.
Netflix were just incredible partners. They were amazingly supportive, but also let us tell the story we wanted to tell. It is an amazing thing to be making something that, you know, is going out to, what is it, you know, like 190 territories worldwide.
125 million subscribers at the moment. So yeah. I mean, it's an audience that you can't even begin to fathom, and the reach of it is incredible. And we really hope that, you know, we can speak to all of those audiences all around the world and be able to sort of, you know, give them the entertainment that the story deserves. We'd love to do a second season. We're just at that sort of one funny stage where we're waiting to see how it goes down, what the response is, and then I think we'll be if everyone's keen to do it, we'd definitely reconstitute it and shoot again as soon as possible.
Excited for the screening?
I am really looking forward to it, actually, because I don't know what to expect, because I don't really know anything about it. So, but it looks great, and I've looked up about it. So no, I'm really looking forward to it because I don't really know what to expect.
This is another great new show from Netflix. Are you a Netflix addict? Do you think it's helping the entertainment industry, more importantly?
Yeah, I am a complete Netflix addict. What have I been watching at the minute? I've been watching The Good Place at the moment. I definitely do, because you find, especially kids as well, seem to be watching more Netflix than they do normal TV, because it's easy access, isn't it? You haven't got to wait for a new episode to come up. Although that is really annoying when they upload the new episodes every day on a week.
Yeah, binge watching, that's where it's at. And when you're not binge watching on Netflix, what have you got coming up yourself at the moment? Obviously, Ackley Bridge has been a huge success and continues to be so.
Yeah, no, I'm filming Ackley Bridge at the moment. And that comes, I think that's coming out in June. And we've got double the amount of episodes as well. And then also, I've got a Netflix series coming out called Safe, which comes out on May the 10th. And all the episodes go off at the same time as well, so there's no waiting around, which is a crime series. And I'm playing a completely different character, so something I've never done before. So, yeah, I'm really looking forward to that.
Can you tell us a bit more about Safe, just generally what the show's about?
Yeah, it's about... it's a crime drama about a girl that goes missing, with Michael C. Hall and Amanda Abington. They play the detectives in it. But I can't really give too much away because... It would make it obvious, but it's definitely worth a watch. There's an amazing, amazing cast. Layla Ruiz and Nigel Lindsay played my parents, and they were a lot of fun to work with. But yeah, no, it's definitely, it's maybe not so much for kids, but it's definitely worth a watch, yeah.
Obviously, for Ackley Bridge, as I say, double the amount of episodes. What can we expect overall from our new batch of episodes, do you think? How does it compare to the series we've already had?
We're a lot braver this series. I think last time we only had 6 episodes, and it was really a taster to see if people would like it and if people liked the stories that we were telling. So now that we've established them, you can... The stories are a lot braver, and you get to know that there's a lot of new characters, and you just get to explore the stories that you already kind of know about, just on a deeper level.
Fantastic to have you here this morning. Are you excited for the screening?
Yeah, very.
Why are you so excited? Are you a fan of kind of kung fu and fantasy stuff? Is that the kind of stuff you like to watch normally?
Yeah, normally I watch stuff on Netflix like that anyway.
And obviously you're watching stuff on Netflix. Do you think Netflix has been good for the entertainment industry, giving us an opportunity to tell a lot of new stories, a lot of new films, new TV shows?
Yeah, but I could see some new films coming. I've watched most of Netflix now anyway.
You've watched most of Netflix. What's your favourite thing on there at the moment?
Designated Survivor. And I've also been watching Hell's Kitchen.
Nice things to be addicted to. When you're not watching Netflix, what else have you got coming up yourself?
Fortnite.
That's just all you're doing right now, playing Fortnite just on a loop.
Yeah, I start filming again tomorrow on the dumping ground. We're filming series 7. I'm looking forward to that a lot.
Obviously, the dumping ground's been a huge hit with fans. Why do you think people connect with the series so much, particularly emotionally?
I don't know, really. I guess it's touching, and sometimes what happens to us happens to people every day.
In terms of the new series, what can fans expect for your character and just for the gang overall?
I don't know if I can say anything. I guess it's going to be emotional.
I am really, really excited. I'm really happy to be here.
Obviously, today's show is kung fu action, fantasy adventure. Are those kind of martial arts, fantasy, those genres that you like to watch normally?
No, but I'm really excited to watch it because I haven't watched a movie like this before.
Of course, this is... a new show that we have from Netflix. Are you a Netflix addict? Are you watching anything on there at the moment?
I'm an absolute Netflix addict. I love it. Netflix. I watch it every day, literally.
What are you watching on there at the moment?
I'm watching Friends at the moment. But I'm really enjoying that. I've watched so much on Netflix.
And when you're not binge-watching Friends on Netflix, what are you doing work-wise at the moment? Is there anything coming up for you?
Well, I'm filming The Dumping Ground at the moment, and we're just going into a really new series, so make sure you tune in. You're just going to enjoy it.
What can fans expect overall from the next series? I think a little bit more emotional, I think.
Yeah. You're just going to have to watch. It's going to be a good series.
Hello, I'm Luke Franks on Scrambled on CITV. How's it going?
Luke, amazing to have you with us this morning. Are you looking forward to the screening?
I am very much, yeah. It's a Sunday morning, so it's a little bit early start. But no, I'm excited. It's going to be good. Going to get myself some snacks. And then that's, I think, a good way to start a Sunday, isn't it?
Yeah. It's a fantastic new show from Netflix. Are you a Netflix addict? And if so, what are you watching on there at the moment?
Yeah, of course, I'm a Netflix addict. What am I watching at the minute? I did... what did I do recently? Well, Friends is obviously on there, so I think at the weekend I quite often sit back and just do a Friends marathon is what I get sort of stuck watching for about 4 hours. And then it asks you on the screen, it's like, do you want to continue watching Friends because you've been watching it for too long? And it's like, yes, I will carry on. So yeah.
You're not binge watching away through 10 seasons of Friends. What have you got coming up yourself at the moment?
All good. So yeah, it's busy at the minute. I just got back from Japan actually, so that's been really cool. So I was out there with some YouTube guys. We were making some videos for online, some fashion stuff. I do quite a lot of style stuff on my Instagram, a little bit of Radio 1 stuff at the minute as well, which is cool. And then I'm DJing quite a lot in the summer, so yeah, looking forward to some good DJ gigs as well. So yeah.
Which YouTube guys were you out in Japan with?
So I was with a guy called Mark Ferris, who is a lovely man, if you know Mark Ferris. Yeah, he's awesome. So we trekked around Japan, and he's got some vlogs that are up, so you can watch those. I'm going to put out a video next week as well. But it's an amazing place. Yeah, it was awesome. So
I'm really excited. I've been having a debate, because sometimes when you come to Netflix screenings, you're not sure if it's a film or a series. The last one I went to see was Lost in Space, which I'm now addicted to. So I'm really excited to see whether this is a series or a movie. I'm not sure yet, but I'm really excited to find out.
It's a series. I'll spoil that one for you. And obviously, I mean, like you say, you're addicted to Lost in Space. What do you think the magic of Netflix is in terms of how it holds our attention and the wonderful things it seems to be giving us on a regular basis now?
Oh, it's brilliant. Like, I don't think I've watched regular TV in a really, really long time. I'm obsessed with Netflix. Everything they bring out, you can like guarantee it's going to be great content. There's going to be amazing actors, new faces, fresh talent. You're not seeing the same people on screen all the time. You kind of get to fall in love with characters and the actors, and then you see them popping up in other Netflix shows, which is always really cool. I'm just a massive fan of Netflix, and to find out this is a series excites me, because now I know I can go and binge watch it at home.
Sure you will. When you're not binge watching this and other great Netflix shows, what have you got coming up yourself at the moment?
So I'm on Capital Extra Radio at the moment, so I've got my show on there. I'm working on a documentary, and I'm going to be doing some stuff with some cool new music artists that are coming out, kind of lots of interview stuff, red carpet stuff, and some kind of live Q&As, which is really cool and fun to do as well.
That's all very exciting, but particularly the documentary. Can you tell us what that's generally about?
It's top secret. I'm not actually allowed to say at the moment. I am under lock and key, but it's something quite serious, quite deep, and really exciting. So I'm looking forward to getting my teeth stuck into that and seeing how the development process goes.
I mean, obviously, like I said, you can't tell the specifics, but just in a general sense, what do you think documentary gives both an audience and a storyteller they don't get from other forms of storytelling?
So the one thing I love about Netflix is the documentaries are just so authentic. They're not polished. They're not cut down for, you know, fitting a certain time frame that TV sometimes restrains documentaries to. With Netflix, you can watch a documentary that, you know, is a couple of hours long, and you know that you can just keep coming back to it. You know, and I just find them really authentic, really real, and they tell a very balanced side to each story. You kind of, it's not one-sided, which is what I like about Netflix. You know, you kind of are left to make up your own mind on things at the end of the doc. So I'm a massive fan of the Netflix documentaries in particular, but just documentaries in general as well. So that's why I myself am kind of looking forward to getting my teeth stuck into a few over the next year or two.
Absolutely delighted to be here. Yeah, I mean, I think it's going to be worth the early Sunday morning start, which I need it to be, because it was too early for me.
Well, this is a series based on a very iconic story. Is it one that you're familiar with in any of the other forms it's been in before?
Do you know what? This is my first journey into Monkey World. But yeah, I'm very excited to see what Netflix have brought to this sort of existing story. And I've been a Netflix convert now for about the past 5 years, and every new series gets better and better, so I'm sure this one will be no different. I think Netflix is great. It's been a huge shift in the kind of stories, the kind of TV shows that are being made. I don't think you would have seen this on telly. Maybe it would have been felt there wasn't the right audience for it, or maybe people just didn't have the budgets in terms of broadcasters to bring these stories to life in the way that they'd like. Now Netflix has that kind of clout. It's basically making, you know, 10 mini movies for each series that it makes, and it's a tremendous thing.
Talking about tremendous things, what have you got coming up yourself the rest of the year and beyond?
Well, for me, a new series of Officially Amazing, the world record show that I do on CBBC, is currently airing. So that's series 7. I don't know how we've got there, but we hit 100 episodes within this series, which we're really excited about. I'm also heading to Russia for the World Cup. So if I don't come back, avenge my death. Hopefully plenty more of the same, more football, more records later in the year as well.
It's my final question. Obviously, like you say, season 7 now for Officially Amazing. Why do you think it is so special and important that we celebrate the extremes of human achievement?
I think people have always wanted to measure the world in some way, and having something like Officially Amazing or Guinness World Records allows you to say who is the fastest, tallest, strongest. And I think there's always a place for that. And there's always a place as well for those kind of achievements which maybe aren't going to hit the headlines, but are still making people unique in their own field. So we've had some amazing things this time round. We had a llama that could do the hurdles, for goodness sake. So, I mean, everyone deserves to see that.